bicep differences, trap differences, you know, side effects of masturbation, things like that. Joking, but everything comes into play, if you know what I mean. So it literally has one job, and you're preventing it from doing that one job of protecting you through the rain. Welcome back, YouTube. We are getting a pull day today, a little bit of a warm up here with some bicep shoulder openers, face pulls, straight arm pull downs, and then sticking to the plan, we'll get some single arm pull downs, chest supported rows, wide grip pull downs, one arm rows, rear delts, and incline bicep curls. Finally, after 6+ weeks, I can commit the workout program to somewhat memory, which probably means it's gonna change soon. Just how it goes. Growing, calories are slightly increasing, so hitting a bit of a carb cycle kind of at the moment as of last check-in. So two high days, two low days, just kind of rotating through those. And yeah, feeling good on a higher carb day today. So should be a good one. I think we have a leak. Fuck. Jersey day. Adapt jersey workouts are always the best, so I should probably just order 5 or 6 more. Shoulders are feeling good, lats are fired up, so we're gonna move on to the single arm pull downs now. Forgot my wraps. Thank you. a very difficult 13, to be honest. 150 pounds per arm. And then smart cam, if you're familiar with smart cams and Prime Fitness, everything's on a setting 5. So most resistance being in the most lengthened and middle range. And it gets a little bit easier in the short and contracted position. That last one wasn't moving. Pre-workout is kicking in. EVP strawberry lemonade. Feeling pumped. It is way harder than it was last week, but that's the goal, is pushing the intensity. So that's how I should be feeling. We're gonna go slightly lighter, hit a couple more reps, and then move on to chest supported rows. Like after every single set, I'm like Henry Cavill in The Witcher.
Fuck. Fuck. Fuck.
Very clear when you like look at a program and you're like, What movement on here do I hate the most? It's clearly probably the hardest exercise, and it's also the one you probably are gonna benefit the most from. Like, I was doing legs yesterday, and I have to do like Bulgarians, and I'm like, I fucking hate these. I don't wanna do them, but I probably am gonna benefit the most from them. And for some reason, it's this movement. Chest supported rows. Yeah. Doing the one arm cable row, trying to focus on just that elbow path, keeping it close to the body and keeping it as low as possible the entire time. Trying not to use a whole lot of momentum, and really just once I can't get my elbow into my rib cage, counting that as failure. I could surely knock out some partials and kind of keep pulling and strengthen from that length and range, but once I can't get a full, maybe 70, 75% of a whole range, whole rep, then I just cut it off there. Oh. Lats are getting pretty tired. Pushing it harder on the single arm and then the chest supported rows. Noticeably heavier than previous weeks, but residual movements have suffered as a result. So we're gonna move on to rear delts, go back to lats with some straight arm pull downs and then biceps. Focusing on growing the rear delts, path is important, but the intention is probably the most important thing. What I mean by that is the intention should be to pull the cables out wide the entire time, try to create width as much as possible, as opposed to just focusing on retracting your shoulder blades and pulling back. It's very easy for you to use your rhomboids and other muscles to retract, but the rear delts to create width. A great lat exercise, the straight arm pull down. Isolates the lats, a little bit of tricep, a little bit of rear delt, but for the most part, you're not having to worry about grip at least. So while the other exercises are gonna use your grip, fatigue your grip, you can keep the lats active without worrying about your grip by just finding a tricep rope or something like that that allows you to just focus on rotating that shoulder and getting a big stretch at the top position. Thank you. Something about the dumbbell incline curl, I always find I can do really, really well for the first set. Second set's pretty good. By the time I get to the third set, it's a huge drop off. I'm talking like 16 reps, 15 reps, 9 reps. I'm trying to manage my rest a little bit more and make sure I can hit all 4 sets today with as good quality and consistency as possible. Rested about a minute and a half, probably wasn't enough, so get in about 2 minutes maybe, and then knock out this last set. That is a wrap for today. We're gonna get a little pump check as per usual, and then get a little protein in. A little pull day action today. So shoulders, lats, biceps, feeling really good, feeling really pumped. Chest is looking a little bigger, even though we didn't touch it today. So kind of the preview, or the before today, the after you'll see tomorrow, a little chest pump tomorrow with push day. But biceps feeling really good. Was able to hit all 4 sets at the same weight today as opposed to having to drop down. So that feels good. And lats are getting a little wider. More definition in the upper back. Rhomboids popping a little bit. Rear delts, teres minor, teres major, infraspinatus, all that good stuff. Starting to see a little difference and distinction between the two. So that's always nice. Bodybuilding, not always just about size, trying to achieve symmetry too. So balancing out the traps, balancing out kind of all the discrepancies that are just bicep differences, trap differences, you know, side effects of masturbation, things like that. Joking, but everything comes into play, if you know what I mean. So you don't want, you know, one forearm really thick and then the other one, you know, really small or anything. So think about it. Mix grip, double team it, maybe don't grip so hard, all those things. But my little bit of wisdom for today calories are up today, calories go back down tomorrow. And by calories, I really just mean carbs. So fats and proteins kind of staying the same. Just carbing up on my leg day yesterday and then carbing up today for the pulls. We'll go less carbs for push day and then we'll have an off day on Thursday. Travel day heading to Austin. So a little cardio on Thursday while Cass is in seminar, and then we'll get out to Los Campeones, their new north location, on Friday and Saturday, get a good workout in. So that is a wrap again for today. Thanks for watching, liking, subscribing, sharing, loving, hating, all that fun stuff. And we'll see you on the next one. Bye.